our region's business, improving our economy, creating jobs, and strengthening communities. Innovation, collaboration, transformation, and the people making it happen. Join us as we take a closer look at our region's business. Now, here's your host, Bill Flanagan.
Today on Our Region's Business, artificial intelligence meets cancer treatment, one local startup, and it's paving the way for personalized medicine and drug discovery, plus a bipartisan approach to improve pathways to careers for kids across the Commonwealth of Pennsylvania. But first, national attention for our region's leadership in pursuit of criminal justice reform. The Greater Pittsburgh Chamber of Commerce stepped up in recent years on behalf of so-called clean slate legislation, becoming among the first in the nation, Pennsylvania, to adopt the law, which automatically seals the criminal records of individuals with low-level offenses, giving them a better chance to compete for jobs. The Chamber's leadership has turned heads across the country. Other business groups have followed suit. And here to celebrate that is Holly Harris, who is Executive Director of the Justice Action Network. Kevin Jenkins, CEO of Manchester Bidwell Corporation, which is in business to put people into jobs and occupations in our region. And Matt Smith, President of the Greater Pittsburgh Chamber of Commerce and affiliate of the Allegheny Conference, which of course produces this program. Welcome. Good to have you all here.
Thank you.
So Holly, tell me about it. What is the Justice Action Network exactly?
So we are the largest bipartisan organization working at the state and the federal level to reform our broken justice system. And we started back in 2015. We had three target states, and it was Michigan, Ohio, and Pennsylvania. And that is actually where we started our relationship with the Pittsburgh Chamber. You know, we were really trying to start to reach out to trade associations and a lot of folks that care about, you know, workforce development, because in criminal justice reform, you know, certainly if you can be supportive of helping an individual successfully re-enter society, you know, that's getting jobs, that's being able to secure adequate housing and being able to support your family so you can turn away from crime for good. And so chamber groups, you know, we thought that would be a natural fit, you know, that they would really be excited about having a more robust workforce. You know, we called up the Pittsburgh Chamber, and I remember talking to Matt Smith and his team, and they were really excited about being supportive of criminal justice reform efforts, not just because it improves, you know, workforce development, but because, you know, it was important to them to provide second chances to people who had made mistakes. And so it turned into an amazing partnership.
It was only a couple of years ago, Matt. So what was going on here in our region that made you so receptive to Holly's pitch?
Yeah, as Holly said, it's really about providing opportunity. And we had a study a few years ago called Inflection Point that demonstrated that this region, like many others, it's not a unique problem for this region, but we are going to have a workforce shortage over the next 10 years in a very acute manner. And so we were charged by our board, and the board deserves a lot of credit for saying, go out and try to solve this problem using whatever means necessary. And we identified criminal justice reform as a way, certainly not the solution to the entire problem, but it's a big part of the puzzle, big piece of the puzzle to make sure that we have enough workers to fill the open jobs in this particular region. And so it's really, for us, at the intersection of workforce as well as economic inclusion, to make sure that we're providing as many individuals in the region and in Pennsylvania the opportunity to go out and earn a living and support their family, you know, which is what everyone wants to do.
All right, Kevin, do you see this? I mean, is this a real issue when you're working with the population you're working with to try to create opportunity for them?
Yeah, absolutely, Bill. And I'm glad to hear Matt use that word a couple times, opportunity, because as you know, for the past 50 years, Manchester Bidwell Corporation and through its affiliate Bidwell Training Center has done just that. We provide skills training for those individuals who are chronically unemployed, underemployed, or people in transition. But as of late, we've seen a whole new population of students come through our doors that college may not be an option for them, but they want to work, they can work, and they want to stay here in the city. So I was very excited about this piece of legislation and it passing, because it gave those individuals opportunities to pursue skills training with us and not have to worry about, you know, a mistake I made in my early 20s and now I'm in my 30s, 40s, and now I'm not going to qualify for one of the jobs that Matt had just mentioned.
Well, we got to get him one of these too.
And you know, you think about how many of us have done stupid things when we were kids. Unfortunately, you get past it and it never has lasting implications. But people who find themselves caught up in the criminal justice system, leaving that behind is impossible often.
Absolutely. And many of them may not have the resources, you know, to take a look at, you know, is my record still valid? You know, has it been expunged? Has it not been expunged? Until they get to that point where they're applying for a position, and then they come to find out, well, you don't qualify because you may have this misdemeanor on your record still, and you don't qualify for a job.
I know we've been talking about this in our region, Holly, for several years, but how big a deal was this when the Greater Pittsburgh Chamber actually stepped up and said, yeah, we want to work with you?
Well, it was pretty significant because, as you can understand, you know, several years ago when we were talking about how we wanted to help people in jails and prisons, that was a tough sell to politicians. But if you've got a chamber group that's full of very influential business leaders that are leaning in to do the right thing for people, and to be clear about what a big deal it is, one in three American adults has a criminal record. Wow. So a third of our country has a more difficult time finding employment. So for a chamber group like the Pittsburgh Chamber, you know, that has the gravitas of that organization to step up and be supportive, that's why we wanted to present them with the Excellence in Advocacy Award. There were only four given out, and of course we work all over the country and at the federal level, and we really felt like, you know, what Matt and his team were able to do in terms of, like, turning the tide for criminal justice reform in Pennsylvania was really incredibly significant and helped start a movement.
Wow. Well, I love the Lucite thing, but frankly, Matt, at the event that you had for Holly, I was more impressed with the other gift you brought us from Kentucky.
Yes, so there's a barrel head. There's a beautiful barrel head that was signed by three country music stars that sang at our event. One of them was John Carter Cash, the son of Johnny Cash. Lots of significance there with prison reform. It was really amazing because the barrel head was actually created by formerly incarcerated people who are employed by Old World Timber, which is, you know, an organization in Kentucky. So we wanted to present that to you all, it really, I think, underscores how grateful so many people are to the Pittsburgh Chamber and what you all were able to do for our movement.
Well, and that's wonderful to hear. And the big thing for us has been, you know, from the board down, we were charged with finding solutions to the workforce and economic inclusion problem. And the fact that there is such bipartisan support for an issue like this, the great work that Holly and her team does across the country is a real testament to the way that this issue has changed, and the perception of this issue has changed, where now you have Democrats joining arms with Republicans trying to solve this problem. And it's one of the few issues, both at the state level and at the national level, where you have that kind of bipartisan consensus. And I think it speaks volumes to the importance of the issue.
Wow. Well, and it's true. We seem to have fewer and fewer of those issues today, so it's absolutely wonderful to see this kind of bipartisan. Congratulations on the great work. Hopefully it's going to create all kinds of opportunity for a lot of people. Holly Harris from the Justice Action Network, Kevin Jenkins from Manchester Bidwell, Matt Smith from the Greater Pittsburgh Chamber. Thank you all so much. Congratulations.
Thank you.
Next up, a bipartisan initiative to improve the workforce pipeline in Pennsylvania with a package of legislation aimed at K-12 education. Please stay with us.